on. They say his brain isn't functioning anymore, and they want to shut off his machines. But Jacob's the only thing in the world that matters to me. I don't know how to help him, and it's tearing me up inside. I just feel so helpless, so damn angry. Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't!
It doesn't appear that there's some way to help him, but I have a feeling we're going to find out the answer to all this in the cockpit. It makes sense, it's the only place you haven't been. Greetings? Nobody. Dead Julia? What is... is that a person? No, it looks like a chair on a chair.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to...
interrupt.
Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
Wow.
Dead and done, just the way I like them.
What is that? Dead and done? Dead and dumb? Something like that. Alright, well. Oh, cool. Look at that. I can see space outside. That would freak me out. Could you imagine if you were really standing on this? And you knew that was really space outside. Actually, in real life, you probably couldn't see all these stars because there'd be nothing for them to reflect off of. If that makes any sense. What I've always heard is that we can see the stars because they're reflecting off the atmosphere. I mean, you'd be able to see some of them, maybe the big ones, just because they're shining light, you know, like a flashlight. All right, so we gotta shut this guy's life support down. It's just the right thing to do. I wonder if Tally's gonna tell us. Hold on.
You did the right thing, Shepard.
He didn't want to be in life support. I figured she'd know that after listening to the logs with me.
You did the right thing, Shepard.
No matter what I do, she tells me I did the right thing, Shepard. That's too funny. Alright. Oh, wrong way. See if something else explodes on us. So Julia set all these to explode? So that nobody else could, you know... oh, that's a dead end. Nobody else would shut them down? I mean, that... they're adrift for how long? How long were these logs in place? To ship. There you go. Interesting. Gemini Sigma. Yeah. That's the only thing I have. In hand is the crime lord. Han Solo. planets. Patatanless. Patatanless is a large rock world with an unusually thin atmosphere of hydrogen and carbon monoxide. The frigid world's crust contains extensive deposits of uranium and occasional loads of naturally occurring plutonium. With a total mass more than four times that of Earth, Patatanless should have a significantly thicker atmosphere. This unusual feature has flagged it as worthy of scientific investigation, but the need for expensive amounts of radiation shielding has deterred interest. Light metal surveyed. Scans from orbit have detected a large amount of beryllium. What is this orbit? Far Crothu. It's a pretty far off Crothu. A standard gas hydrogen helium gas giant, Far Crothu is only distinguished by its moons. Several dozen of them have been sculpted into the likeness of an arthropodal alien race not yet known to Council science. Interesting. Radiometric dating suggests the moons were worked over 500,000 years ago. Mavigon. We can land on this one. Level 1 cold hazard. Mavigon is a small rock and ice planet with a thin atmosphere of ammonia and methane. The surface is frozen and mainly composed of tin with deposits of potassium. The planet has a rudimentary ammonia-based life, mainly concentrated around geothermal vents deep underground. Severe storm cycles are common due to limited visibility. Navigation may be difficult. -124°C. Look at the others first. Huningtoe. Huningtoe is a Jovian-sized gas giant with a standard hydrogen-helium atmosphere. Traces of methane give the planet its distinct cobalt-blue tint. Spectral analysis indicates its extensive ring system is mostly composed of ice crystals. Huningtoe has an exceptionally powerful magnetic field, which creates strong radio interference throughout the inner system. I'm saying the wrong words here. Paravin. Paravin is a small, unremarkable rock world. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of calcium with deposits of aluminum. Paravin's low mass has left it tidally locked to the star Han. If there were any resources of value, mining stations could be established on this relatively temperate twilight band. Matriarch's writings recovered. Scans of Paravin revealed an unmanned station in geosynchronous orbit. Your salvage team found no evidence on the origins of the station, but they did find one of Matriarch Delanaga's writings on board. Cool. Alright, now we will land on Mavigon. Just like that. I need to level my people up too. We leveled up on that freighter. Level 2 hazard, wow. Oh, we didn't level up, I guess. No, that was just the sound of us. I mean, we're almost there. Really, we're almost there. Another 109 points and Brittany Shepherd will... what do you call it? Level. And the same for all of us, actually. Okay, so we're gonna get there. We'll get there. Debris and Syndicate Hideout. Let's go for debris. Of course it's up there. We'll go around this way, though. I'll try to, anyway. Hopefully it'll make it easier to get around. Crap. Whee! Oh my god! Pretty wild. Go around this thing. Try to go around. How far are we? Oh, we're getting there. Doobie doop 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 doop. These guys do this on purpose, putting stuff behind everything. They're like, drive around, will ya? Where is it? Up top? Oh no, right here. We're gonna take damage out here, aren't we? Okay. Oh no. Not gonna make it. Incendiary rounds 5 and combat scanner 6. Back in the Mako. Combat scanner 6, yeah. There you go. And we will get rid of the 5s. Oh, I have an extra slot on this. Ooh. I did not know this. Okay, so she's using a 6 as well. We can also pick another thing. Okay, right now we have rail extension 6, plus 26 damage and minus 20% heat absorption. Increases weapon overheating. Kinetic stabilizer, plus 18% weapon stability. What do you think? I don't want to overheat more. That's quite a bit, 20%, I think, maybe. Let's take kinetic stabilizer. I didn't know we'd get a third slot. I wonder if that's dependent on level or the gun. I'm thinking the gun. Yeah, because he doesn't have second slots. See, he has 5. And 6 on this. Alright, so map. Right here to the hideout. Alright. Yeehaw! Flatlands here. Farther apart than it looks, you know. Not sure which side they're on. One way or another, we'll find out. Well, I can go around anyway. Alright, it's getting hard to see. Up top? See, we're passing it by. At some point, something will be on top of the mountain. I think we found that one that's on top of... Yeah, this is a mountainous region. How the hell did we get up there? Right? And we'll be sitting ducks as we struggle to get off the edge of this... Over the edge of this thing. Maybe we can go up that way. A little more gradually. yeah, not really. Oh, come on, turn! Not that much. My god, this guy has really secured himself. Surprise! I said I would knock into these things. Can I knock into them? Not really. Now we level up. So as long as we don't die. Nice. If you don't fall off here, that'll be great. Shift key. Cool. So do I, Rex. So now we found things we can't knock over. Except for these things. Looking for the entrance. Is that an entrance or a... Oh, turning the wrong way here. Oh, this way in, okay. Let's get this crap out of the way. There you go.
Securing point.
Okay, Tally. Alright. What was that? Medical kit. Plus one Medigel. Big fight here, I'm sure. Oh, lots of baddies. Z-Wop. I really want to use my arrow keys now. Oh my. Okay, you got him. They're all around us, man. Game over, man. Game over. You destroy me? Oh, see, now I have inventory added. I noticed that for the first time. Look at him popping back and forth. He's the last one, right? Second crimelord defeated. Crimelord defeated. That's both of them. No doubt Helena Blake will be overjoyed to learn that these two scum are no longer a problem. She's probably as big a scum as either of them.
All clear.
Yeah, let's look around. Oh, look at these. These are like these doors. That door that we found that we couldn't get through. Huh. They kind of have a Prothean-like look to them, or a Geth look. Actual plants. Wow. Don't see that very often in bad guys' hideouts. Medical kit. Still getting more metagel. I know I increased how much I could have at one time, I just don't know how much that is. Offhand. Alright, door control. Alright, so this is the only way out, but then we fork the junction there. Wetware kit? What's that? Wetware. Unity Amp 6 and Polaris 6. It's not very often I find these amp things. I also got a pistol and an assault rifle. I don't think either of them is what we can use. Pistol? No, another Edge 6. Assault rifle. Banshee 6, yeah, we have that already. You sell all this crap. Look at that, we got more amps now. So we're using Solaris Amp 1. Power bonus. Polaris. Ooh. Ooh, look at that. This is much better. Look at that. I think we picked up the Unity Amp, though. So I guess I didn't realize I had this thing. Same power, but much greater duration. And much greater cooldown bonus. Took it. Give him this. Omni tool. Well, her Omni tool. All right. Yeah, we'll take this. Pretty powerful now. Medical station. What, just to get metagel? Oh no, I'm not gonna make it now. Ah. Could have been a contender. Phoenix 6. Oh, for Quarian and Turian. I want to check on Rex's armor.
Let's go.
Not yet. First we'll check your armor. So it's Turian armor. No, not Turian. Quarian. Oh, hell yeah. This is much better. That's a pretty cool look, isn't it? It is, I like it. Better than that dull yellow. That's pretty awesome. Anyway, for Rex. I think he's using heavy armor. So yeah, this isn't gonna be a bonus for damage protection. Look at those shields though. Wonder if that's worth it. Just for the shields? I don't know. Oh, what are these things? Drugs? Chemicals? Formula? Oh my my. Yeah, that was... Oh, barely made it. Stiletto 7, Tornado 7, Raptor 6. This could be some good stuff. Pistol, shotgun, assault rifle. Oh, look at that. Nice. Of course I'm gonna give her the best. Check out this shotgun. Oh, it's what we already have. Tornado 7. Okay. Does Rex have one? No, he has 6. Okay, good. Cool. Oh, he's got 3 slots. So we can take another, I guess, rail extension. Don't have anything else right now. And, yeah. Okay, so assault rifle. It's one of these. Okay. I will sell all this crap eventually. Medical kit. 1 and 1. Technician kit. Grenade and weapon upgrade. Cryo explosive and combat scanner 6. Using incendiary now. Get rid of this one. And a combat scanner 6. Oh, we have 3 slots here now. What's she using? What is this? Improved sighting? Give her the combat scanner. We have another one, I guess. Yep. Okay. Malfunctioning objecto. Medical interface 6, kinetic stabilizer 7, armor and weapon. Now, Tally's already got it, right? Oh, she's got 5. Okay, good. I'm just gonna get rid of this old one. And I know I have at least 6 as well. Yep. And what's the other thing we found? I remember. Kinetic stabilizer 6. Oh, aren't I using that? I want to upgrade mine then if I'm using that. This is the site, I think, and this is. Wait. Yeah. There we go. More damage, I don't know. Let's give him that. Get rid of the heatsink 3, it's so old. You can overheat a tiny bit more, but it's okay. So we can't even get to the other side of this room. Apparently. It's all packed full of crap. Oh, I got stuck. Okay. Time to leave this joint. That eerie music. And how do I get out of this place again? Good. I think this is a great place to stop off. I can cross this off. I got both crime lords, as if that should be any rush on that. Still gotta go to the Kepler Verge for to find the Herschel planet or Herschel system to find Dr. Salian for Garrus. We have to go to the Hawking Ada cluster, Century system for this look at the strange biotic commune. You have to go to Argus Row Cluster, Hydra Planet, for a strange transmission. That's an old one. As well as the Hawking 8, that's pretty old too. Voyager Cluster, Yangtze System, for the Cerberus. To help Admiral Kahoku. Cerberus on Binthu Planet, actually. And also the Voyager Cluster for the Amazon system for food shipments. Something about food shipments. The Maroon Sea Cluster, Vostok system for inventory facility for Exogenocorp. That's a Exogenicorp. Armstrong Cluster, who knows what system for where the Geth are amassing, and the Maroon Sea Cluster, Metano system for inventory samples. I think I wrote. I have a small little notepad. So I had to squeeze it as best as I could. So we're going to go to some of those other systems first. You know, get the side crap out of the way first. So thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.